music industry is an extremely competitive place for female artists.
But after a bit of a break, Canadian singer Avril Lavigne is back to prove she still has what it takes.
Richard Wilkins caught up with her for this exclusive. Tell me
she's the 26-year-old Canadian pop star who burst onto the scene back in 2002 and unleashed a string of hits. Avril Lavigne was indisputably one of the hottest acts of the decade. Three hit albums, sales of over 30 million. And now, after a break of 4 years, she's back with Goodbye Lullaby. All my life I've been good, but now I think you're what the hell.
What sort of pressure do you feel when you're making a new record?
I'm really relaxed. I'm not feeling any pressure these days. It's all about having fun and enjoying what you do.
Is there a time when you sort of, you know, you're halfway through the record or whatever and you're recording, you obviously love it, but you think, oh, I hope the fans are still there for me?
Yeah, definitely. And I've been working a lot over the last 4 years. I spent 2 of those years promoting and touring my last album. So I've still been able to connect with them. And they've just been incredible. But yeah, I hope that they love the new stuff. So what if I go out
on a million dates? Avril's new video is out today and features her mum.
I always have my family come to, my brother and sister come to my video shoots and stuff, and my dad. I guess that was my mom's first video, so I was like, you gotta be in the video. So she makes a cameo when I'm in the vintage clothing store, and she's looking through clothes, and I walk in and I say, hey, Mom!
Not only is she an international recording artist, she's also famous for her look, which led to her creating her own fashion range.
Really, what it's been for me is just another way to be creative. Fashion is a huge part of what I do. And it's really great because I have my own style. I like to dress a little rock and roll. And so I'm designing clothing for me. And if my fans like my style, you know, they can check it out. So it's been a lot of fun.
Late last year, Avril and ex-husband Derek Whibley divorced. So how much of the new album Goodbye Lullaby is inspired by the breakup?
Well, I'm a pretty deep person, and so I've always kind of been able to go there. On this album, I chose to really go there. A lot of my stuff was previously on the other albums more pop rock and like boy bashing and playful. This album is more emotional, it's deeper, it's very honest, and it was time for me to do that.
It's a pretty competitive business she's in. Britney, Katie, Gaga, Christina, colleagues or rivals?
I definitely don't view it as a competition. I think we all end up helping each other out because we're all doing the same thing. We're all chicks out there, independent, you know, making music, and I think we support each other, really. I am so excited to come back to Australia. It's been a really long time, and I will be there on my tour May, June. So the first leg of my tour, so the beginning.
La,
la, la, la,
la, la. La.
She needed that.
Yeah.
And Avril's new album, Goodbye Lullaby, is in stores on March the 14th. But we have got another great album here on the desk this morning, the Flood Relief album, which Sony Music has just put out. Dennis Handlin is a superstar. He's the head of Sony Music, and he is the one that is always there to help whenever he can. Remember he did the Bushfires one,
mm-hmm.
and how good that was?
Yep.
There's 3 CDs there. Have you got a favourite on there?
Now, listen, Dennis Handlin gave me a call when I was up there doing the floods, and he goes, Carlos, mate, I can't believe what people are going through up there. I cannot believe. What can we do to help? And then he came up with his own answer while we were on the phone conversation. And he goes, we're going to do another CD, and this one is an absolute cracker, as Lisa says. It's got the Oils, Powderfinger, just a great collection of music. Springsteen, Pink, Sting, Grinspoon, Ben Lee. It's a great mixture, isn't it?
Kings of Leon, Foo Fighters, Darryl Braithwaite, Screaming Jets. Everyone is there. You know how you get compilation albums and you think, oh, that's filler, that's filler, that's a good one, that's filler. This doesn't have any filler. It is great. In the shops right now.
Fordo likes something there.
No, I'm just noticing how many songs. Every song ever made is on there. There's 60. There are 60 tracks on the one CD. It's fantastic.
It's a knockout.
Good on you guys. Well done to Sony. And you can support all those flood victims by going out and grabbing that sensational CD. well done, guys. Well,